Fond felicitations, fellow Fanilows. Welcome back to Manilow Monday. Today we're on the next to the last track of Barry Manilow's very first album release, Barry Manilow 1. And the song this week is a song written by Buzzy Linhart and Mark Moogie Klingman. It's a classic song because it was originally recorded by the Divine Miss M herself, Bette Midler, in 1972 for her Divine Miss M debut album, released in November of that year. It was a top 40 hit for her in 1973, and Barry's album, Barry Manilow 1, was released in June of that year. But as we talked about before, his initial release of this album was not very well received. It only sold about 35,000 copies. It did much better when it was remastered and re-released after his hit on his second album, Mandy. They re-released it as Barry Manilow 1, and I had a huge hit with Could It Be Magic. So, as I was recording the song for my album to share with you today, I noticed there's a slight skip, which is one of the problems with vinyl back in the day, but is in one section is barely noticeable. But this album has been with me for 40 years, so what can I say? I clean it regularly, but I also picked up this copy at a secondhand store back in the day. In fact, it has, when I looked at the label, it has Chris McDaniel, the name Chris McDaniel, written in ink across the label. So if Chris is listening, thanks for giving it up so I could share these memories. Anyone of a certain age, say 40 or over, you're going to instantly recognize this song. It was featured in an episode of The Muppets back in the day with Candace Bergen. Younger viewers might remember it. The donkey sang it in the movie Shrek. So let's have a listen, shall we? This is just a great song all the way around. To be honest, I was a little surprised that Barry did this song so soon after Bette Midler had her hit with it. Most artists, at least these days, They try not to copy other songs so soon after they're released by other artists. So while I do like Barry's version, it's hard not to compare it with Bette's iconic version. Both are strong, but again, when I hear this song in my head, I hear Bette Midler singing it. The song itself, it's a great tribute to the importance of friendship. It's well written. The lyrics are amazing. The melody's catchy. It's bouncy. It's memorable. All the traits that you need to have a good song. The song's been covered by other artists through the years. It's just a timeless classic. And I think people for years to come will enjoy this song. So ultimately, both versions of Friends are excellent. It really comes down to personal experience, which version you prefer. If you're looking for classic pop, you might want to listen to Barry. If you're looking for more soulful interpretation, because Bette, her vocals do lots of stuff out of tempo and out of melody. It's a lot of ad-lib, improv. It's an amazing version as well. If you're looking for that kind of thing, that's the version maybe you should go look for. Either way, you can't lose. You just can't. But thanks for joining me today. And a quick reminder, my album Forever Fanilow is available. Links are in the description. Like, subscribe, do all the stuff. And then I will talk to you again soon. And until then, take care, fellow Fanilows.